Hey guys, Chris here, and it's been a while since I uploaded, but thankfully now I got a video that I can make, and it's about the Year 6 reveal that wrapped up a few hours ago on the Rainbow Six livestream, and I'm here to bring you basically a recap of what happened and what you should expect to see in this new season. I would also like to let you know that there are sections to this video. The timestamps are in the description, so if you're looking for a specific topic that I'm going to be talking about, then look down there, because then you'll find it, it'll be helpful, and now you won't have to just watch the whole video just for your part to appear. So first off, here's the roadmap for Year 6. Obviously, we're getting an Argentine operator in Season 1, Floors, and then Europe operators in Season 3 and Season 4, but Season 2 is a little interesting, though. They said they are going to the prairies of North America, and that the operator released in Season 2 will be from Nakoda. Now, I don't know who these people are, but they were originally from the United States, but are now in Western Canada, so I guess we'll be seeing kind of another Canadian operator, possibly. Okay, so moving on from that, you can see below those that there are map reworks, obviously with Border for this season, Crimson Heist. There's a favela rework for Season 2. There are going to be multiple small reworks in maps on Season 3, so not just one map. And there is going to be an Outback rework for Season 4 with the occasional events throughout the season, with new gameplay features being added every season. Okay, and now moving on to the new season, Crimson Heist. Obviously, the new operator Floors is coming March 16th. Through the Battle Pass and the Premium Pass, and then available 2 weeks later to purchase with Renown and R6 credits. I will say this though, it is a little better since there's really no more Year 6 pass, I'm guessing, and now mainly everybody can get the pass and get the operators, but having to wait 2 weeks for the op if you don't buy the pass, I mean, that's a little overboard right there, to be honest. I would prefer if they switch it back to 1 week, obviously. I mean, maybe they'll change it, but right now I'm not too okay with this. And onto this new op, Floors. He's from Argentina, with his gadget being an explosive drone that can clear out gadgets, open unreinforced walls, and even kill people with it. But there is a timer, so you can get the hell out of there while you can, though. Here is his loadout. He has an AR-33 assault rifle with the SR-25 DMR and the GSH-18 pistol, along with stun grenades and a claymore as well. Now, like I said, there is a map rework in Crimson Heist, and it's Border. I'm not sure why it wasn't Bank, but it's Border, and it's actually alright seeing some footage from it, but I'm gonna wait until I actually play it, which will be March 16th, but for now, it does look alright. And along with the launch of Crimson Heist will also be the match replay system as well. Now, before you get too excited, I just want to let you know that it will only be released on PC as a beta. It will not be available on console for some time soon. If I had to guess, it will probably be like Season 3, Season 4-ish, but for now it's just a beta on PC. And once everything is good with the PC beta of Match Replay System, then they'll implement that into the console version of Siege. Now, what they also talked about during the livestream was that there is going to be a change with the test server for Year 6 and beyond. Instead of just using it to test out for, you know, just the new season, they're going to be also testing out more stuff beyond that, which in my opinion is great because this game has a lot of good potential for such good features, and now this is pretty much a good testing point for them to do it on. And now I'm going to list some of those stuff they're going to test in there. The first one is going to be an attacker repick system, which is a very, very good option in my opinion. So let's say you picked Ashe, and you know, you're fine with it, but your teammates are not, and they want you to switch to a Hard Breacher. Well, no problem, because now with this, you can switch from Ashe to another Hard Breacher, such as Thermite, Habana, and so on and so on. Now there is going to be a new sidearm for some of these ops, and it's going to be called the Gone 6. And I'm not even joking with that name, that's actually what it's called. But basically, it's a sidearm, like I said, it's not a gadget, but it's a sidearm. And it's a weapon to destroy gadgets, pretty much. It fires like an Ash charge, but you only have one shot with it. This weapon will be available on some operators, not all, but some operators, such as Glaz, Ayana, Dokubi, Lion, Finca, Gridlock, Amaru, and Zero. Another thing they are testing on the test servers is the ability to use cameras and the abilities of those cameras when you're dead. And specifically what I'm talking about is using Maestro Cam abilities and Echo Drone abilities when you're dead. Now this one I am not a fan of, honestly, and I'm pretty sure some people, or actually many people aren't a fan of either. But I will give it a chance, though. Obviously, I haven't played it yet, but I'll give it a chance. Hopefully, they can at least tweak some of the stuff in there so it's not, like, broken. But for now, I'm just not a big fan of it on paper. Alright, so moving on. The developers have now changed the speed and armor, and now armor is now known as health. So now it's just speed and health. So one, armor operators like Ash and such have your standard 100 HP. Two armor operators have now 120 HP, and now three armor operators have 140 HP. Now, like I said, I am going to give it a chance, but it is going to be a little weird to get used to when you're in gunfights, but the thing is, it could save you in some situations where you normally die, but maybe you'll have like an extra 10 or 20 HP left. Now, next up is the reputation system, and this has actually been running in the background for a while now, as confirmed by developers, and here is how it's going to work. So, level 0 to 1 is a negative rating, which you don't want to be aiming for. Level 3 is a neutral rating, and level 4 to 5 is a positive rating, which is what most of you want to be aiming for. Now, you can see here that if you reach the high tiers, then you'll be rewarded with stuff, and if you're in the low, then you'll be limited to what you can do in Siege. Now, there is going to be some visual changes to the menus, and I think these look good in my opinion with all the colors and stuff, and it adds a nice touch to it. But then again, it kind of reminds me of one of those crappy mobile games, but to be honest, I do like the operator screen now and the skin selector screen. It actually looks more detailed and more in-depth now. And now, onto a big feature coming into the first part of Year 6, the streamer mode. Now, you can pause to get a good look at this, but right now it's looking very good, and hopefully Ubisoft can continue to improve on the streamer mode, and hopefully Siege can lower its stream snipers and Q snipers, hopefully. You know, now just saying that and listening to that again, it's such a bold statement and one can dream, but I mean, if Ubisoft really does well with the streamer mode, then well, those stream snipers and Q snipers could be gone. Alright, so on to cosmetics. This is a feature that I wanted for so long, and it's now we have the ability to use elite skins and animations with regular cosmetics. And as you can see by these pictures, it's going to be fun to see. That Tachanka one, by the way, is so funny. I love that one. But it's going to be very cool to see what people come up with in terms of combinations, so I don't know, I'm really excited for this feature. It's one that I think myself and probably many people wanted for a long time now. And also in the live stream, there was another elite skin revealed. It's the Resident Evil Zafia Elite, and this looks very, very cool. Obviously, this is the second crossover because last year they did Lara Croft and that Ash Tomb Raider Elite. Well, now we have the Resident Evil Zafia Elite, and oh man, it looks very, very cool. Now, starting tomorrow, February 22nd as well, Cali will have an elite skin too, as you're seeing in the background here, and also if you saw it in the CGI cinematic, that was her elite skin. It looks pretty cool, to say the least, but I'm probably not gonna get it though because I suck with Cali, and plus, I'm kinda mixed on it. I know I said it was cool, but I'm kinda mixed on it now. Oh, and I forgot, there are two more regular skins coming to Siege by Capcom artist Ikumi Nakamura. I'm so sorry if I pronounced that wrong, but she has designed two skins for Dokubi and Echo, and as you're seeing right now on screen, they look pretty cool, to say the least. I will definitely buy these when they come out. And also, I forgot to mention as well, these will be released March 2nd, so I'd say good 2 weeks from now, so yeah. And finally, before I leave you guys off, there is going to be a Rainbow Six Siege board game, and I'm not joking when I say that. Here's the picture. It says it's releasing summer 2021. It's certainly an interesting thing to see, but I'll definitely be on the lookout to get it when it comes out. So otherwise, guys, this was a hefty video to make, and if you enjoyed it, please make sure to like and subscribe as it helps me out and also tells me that you guys really enjoy this and you want more. And yeah, hopefully all of you are excited for Year 6 like I am and the future of Siege 2. Hopefully you guys have a great day, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.